somebody asked me what Shani can do, Saturn can do in your life. Saturn can do wonderful things. Saturn can make you a king, or he can make you a pauper. He can make you a sad, gloomy person. Or he can make you a person who has his third eyes completely powerful, having a long extended vision about life, big planner, and implementation of big plans. Saturn can do that. Provided Saturn is good for you in the chart, the Saturn is bad for your chart, then where it is sitting, in the house it is sitting, it can destroy that house. It can create a lot of issues and problems for that. I'll tell you, if your Saturn is not good in the chart, what you can do. In general, in certain points I will have discuss about the Saturn in this video. Suppose the Saturn is sitting in your Lagna house, the first house, then what happens? You have a melancholic, disposition, means loneliness and sadness in you. Sitting there, it will look at the third house, that will give you money. Look at the seventh house, your marriage house, creating sadness in the marriage. Melancholy in the marriage, sad marriage. A relationship can break. A relationship can go for a six. It can create total sadness and a vacuum in a married relationship. Sitting there, it will look at the house of profession, that the 10th house makes you a multitasking guy. So you can see that one Saturn sitting in the Lagna, giving you melancholy and sadness, giving you money also, and also creating sadness in the marriage, in the relationships also. So depends where it is sitting. For example, it goes to the second house. If Saturn is sitting in the second house, then which other house we will look at? From second house, we look at third house, means second, then third, the fourth. It will look at the fourth house, means again creating sadness and melancholy in you. Sitting in the second house, Saturn will make you spend unnecessarily, wasteful expenditure. You spend money like you throw water, you know. The discerning capability, the control, mental control, not to spend or be a judicious spender, it does not happen. Whatever you earn, money goes away. That is the problem. If the Saturn sits there, Saturn sitting over there, we look at where? It will look at the 8th house and 9, 10. It will also look at the 11th house, house of income. So the Saturn sitting in the second house, we look at the house of income, 11th house. It will give you money. It will give you money, but all the money will go away. You will be always wondering, why is that I'm not able to save money? Why the money is coming, I know. But where this money is going? And the situations can happen. Some relative will fall sick, they will ask money. You know, and unnecessary cheating can happen to you. You planned for a trip and you paid some money to some agency, and then the agency vanished from there. You put money in somewhere and the company closes down, the share market goes down, or you buy something, useless things in your life. So unnecessary expenditures keep on coming. So whatever you earn after your hard work, all goes away. Saturn, if it is sitting in the fifth house, then it will look at the marriage house. First, marriage house is gone. Saturn looking, sitting in the fifth house, the house of creativity, your creativity goes for a six. Okay, so third house, 1, 2, 3, third house means a marriage house, as I told you, creating melancholy. 4, 5, 6, and looking at the house of income, yes, it will help you. If the Saturn sits in the Bhagya house, 9th house, then you had it. Then your vision clarity will be totally blurred, you know. Saturn looking at the Bhagya house, luck house, or sitting over there, can create a lot of obstacles. It's like, you know, giving example to you, is then the main switch that is a problem. And if all the light points of the house are working, but if there is a small problem in the main switch, what will happen? Then nothing will work in the house. But the main switch is the center of all the energies. So when the Saturn sits over the luck house, then your efforts in life, they don't bear much fruit. Okay, sitting over there, it can give you things like intuition, and it can give you parapsychological experiences. You can feel something which others cannot feel. These kind of things can happen. You can have some kind of dreams, which were dreams. Saturn can do that. All these things are happening because Saturn influences the third eye. The place of Saturn is your forehead, which is the third eye. The pineal gland, we call it midbrain. So Saturn can give you a lot of problem there. If Saturn sits in your house of profession, that is the 10th house, then it will look at the house of marriage. So it will give you multitasking ability, you will do well in your job, but then you will have sadness in the marriage. You have seen people very high position in the corporate world, in the companies or other fields, or in the business also. They will be doing extremely well in the profession, but their married life is, it can happen. It can spoil the marriage totally, create the sadness in the marriage. Okay. So depending on where the Saturn is sitting, it can give you good or bad result. If it is bad in the chart altogether, then wherever it sits, it never give you good results. It will give you bad result only. So if the Saturn is good for you, and if you want to boost the energy, you can use one blue sapphire stone. But then you also take into consideration where all it is looking. I give an example of Saturn sitting in the house of profession. If you wear a blue sapphire stone, it will improve in your profession, but it will take a toll in the married life, because Saturn is looking at the married life. If you wear a blue sapphire stone, in that case, what you should do? You can wear a 17 Mukhi Rudraksh. For Saturn, 17 Mukhi Rudraksh is very, very safe to wear if you don't know much about the astrology, and if you don't have the opportunity to meet a good astrologer. And if you are taking a decision and you think that Saturn has to be made all right, then instead of wearing a blue sapphire stone, you be safe and wear a 17 Mukhi Rudraksh. It works beautifully and powerfully. So Saturn is it's like a GPS, I tell, you know. I say the GPS is like a GPS, and it's like your third eye, vision about life. So when I talk about the vision about life, then I'm talking about the light throwing outside on the road, so your path of life. So when the light looks at you, when I say the Saturn is sitting on a luck house, means the Saturn is looking at you, your eyes are blurred, so your future is totally blurred. That is why I say Saturn sitting in the Bhagya house, luck house, is not good. In such case, 17 Mukhi Rudraksh can do definitely very well. So but talking about Saturn will take a lot of time. I have tried to compress and give you just a bird's eye view about Saturn, how it affects your life. If you want to know more about this thing, the power of Saturn and stuff, then you can buy my book, Vedic Astrology, available on Amazon, Flipkart, Kobo, and many other platforms all over the world. You can buy that book. The e-books also are available, and read more about Saturn. If you want to consult me anywhere, from anywhere in the world, you can message me through WhatsApp, +91 9845124158. You can log on to my website, www.astrologyrecommendation.com, and www.santoshsharmaa.com, santoshsharmaa.com. Thank you very much for watching this video. Do subscribe and pass it on to your friends, relatives, and who you love. So, bye-bye and take care.